Hello, my name is Jeff with Adash, and this is the DDS tutorial video. In this video, I would like to show you how to monitor machine fault trends. It means that you can record the severity levels of the faults and put them on a timeline. Machine fault trends can be monitored by our FASIT measurement. FASIT stands for Fault Source Identification Tool, and it is a feature for automatic machine fault detection which has been developed by Adash. This feature informs the operator what the probable fault of the monitored machine is. FASIT is able to detect and trend unbalance, misalignment, mechanical looseness, and bearing defect. Let's create the FASIT data cell which you will upload your measurement to. Right-click on the measuring point. Select Add Data Cell and click FASIT. The name of the data cell is FASIT, but you can change that if you wish. Confirm by clicking OK. FASIT requires information about the speed. Define it under Machine or Measuring Point. You can also enter the speed manually in the Vibrio M, or take the speed from a speed probe with the VA3 Pro and other analyzers. Transfer the route including your FASIT measurement to your data collector. Take the required measurements and load the data to DDS. View the FASIT data cell and you can see severity bars for individual faults. The pie chart in the middle represents the distribution of individual faults in percentages. Each fault is represented by a coloured square next to the bar. Therefore, we can see that unbalance is the biggest problem in the example shown here. In the top left corner of the graph window, you can see vibration velocity in the 10 to 1000 Hz range in millimeters per second RMS. This indicates the overall machine condition. Next to it, there is acceleration in the 500 to 16 kHz range in G, RMS, indicating bearing status. In case you have a licensed version of DDS, the range is 500 Hz to 25 kHz, and in the top right corner, you can see the speed. Below, there are indicators of fault severity: unbalance, misalignment, looseness, and the last indicator is a question mark, which is reserved for faults which FASIT is not able to assign to any of the defects mentioned above, therefore for faults which require deeper analysis to find their source. Now let's have a look at the trends. Go to the Graph tab and click on the Graph Type button, or right-click on the FASIT graph and select Graph Type. Now select FASIT plus Trend. Now you can see the FASIT screen of an individual measurement, and the trend of the chosen fault is below. Clicking on individual bar graphs, you can see the fault severity trends of unbalance, looseness, misalignment, and other types of fault. You can move within trend by clicking on the required measurement and you can see the FASIT assigned for this particular measurement. You can also move within trend using the keyboard arrows, clicking on a data list or clicking on individual measurements in the trend graph. The last view option is to see trends only. Right-click on the graph and select Graph Type, Trend. Here you can see all FASIT trends. See the legend for better understanding. The trends are coloured according to the legend. When you click on the y-axis with the requested unit or value, this y-axis is moved to the right and the corresponding trend is highlighted. Hold Shift and use the up and down keyboard arrows to browse between individual trends. You can save the FASIT screen as a picture or PDF and send it by email if you wish. Right-click on the graph and select Export Print. You can print it or save it as a picture and send it as a PDF to your chief of maintenance with the words, "Hey John, one of our critical machines is out of balance. We have to do something before it breaks, man." I hope you find the video useful, and it will help you to understand and use facet measurement type. Thank you for watching.